gentlemen. Introducing. Hello, I'm Rich Rodriguez from Healthy Fit Bootcamp here in Tracy. We're at the sweatshop where we're going to go through another workout. This time, however, we're going to do a pyramid workout. There are several different ways that you can do a pyramid workout, but in this instance here, we're going to do four exercises. We're going to start with one exercise, take a break, then we're going to go two in a row, then take a break, three in a row, break, and then we'll build up to doing all four exercises in a row with no break at all in between those four. It's just one right into the other. However, that doesn't mean we're done. It actually means we're at the halfway point, because when we travel up the pyramid, you know, we have to make our way back down. So we start with one, build up to four, and eventually we'll be down to just one exercise again. It'll all make sense as we're going. Just follow my lead. Now let me show you the exercises. All right, four exercises. The first exercise we'll start with will be push-ups. Several ways to do push-ups. Of course, if you've seen some of the other workouts, you know, but I'm gonna go over them again for you. So push-ups, ideally you wanna be about shoulder width, maybe slightly wider with your hands. Do what you can from your toes. We're gonna be working in 30-second intervals here. So do what you can from your toes. If you are on your toes, you're keeping those hips in. I want your abs tight. I want your glutes tight. Lower your chest between your hands, exhale, and push yourself right back up. So we're here. If it starts to get a little tough from the toes, we can always drop down and finish the round from your knees. So we just go right here, knees come straight down, we still have the abs tight, we're still trying to squeeze your glutes in right here. The main thing is keep those hips in place. I just don't want your butt to be way up in the air. And then of course the third option, we could always do it elevated, meaning on the edge of a counter or a bed or something. In this case, I have a box. A little bit easier if we're up a little higher, but the same idea, hips in, abs tight, chest between your hands. So we'll do push-ups first, and then we'll kind of do like an applejack jump squat here. And what I'm talking about here is we're combining a couple movements. We're doing a few things here with our feet in our torso. We'll start with your feet together. You're gonna hop those feet out nice and wide, like so. And then you're gonna squat down and reach for your opposite toe. Jump those feet back together, squat down and reach for the other side. Now when we're reaching across here, we're leaning forward a little bit, but I don't want you to round the shoulders. So from the side, I don't want it to be like one of these things. I still wanna keep a pretty straight back. So we hop out, and we're right here. Boom, reach across. Spine should be pretty straight. I mean, we are getting that rotation, which is gonna help with your midsection, and then the squats, of course, are gonna get the legs. So, we have our push-up, a little rotating jump squat there. The third exercise, we will come here. Again, we can use the edge of a counter, table, bed, bench, chair, whatever. Something that has an edge that we can sit off of. We're gonna work our dips. Hands are just outside your hips. We're gonna kinda scoot your butt off the surface there. We're gonna stay as close to the box or whatever as we can as you use those arms to lower you straight down and to push you right back up. Now there are several ways to make things a little bit easier for you. Mostly, or the easiest thing to kinda change the intensity would be to change the distance of your feet here. The further away the feet are, or the straighter the legs, a little bit harder it's gonna be. If we're having a hard time towards the end of the round, we can always scoop the feet in a little bit. It makes it a little bit easier, but we're still working those triceps out pretty good. Again, don't get too far away, because when we get way out here and start doing some of this stuff, then you start to put a little bit of funky tension on the shoulders. And we're not into funky tension. We just want to work the muscles out. And then the fourth and final exercise that we will get into will be switch kicks. We just want to keep the heart rate up. We want to keep you moving. Switch kicks are here. You start with one leg up, and you just kick those legs right here. Little hop in between those steps. If we're watching impact or staying away from impact, then just kick minus the hop here. Otherwise, we're right here. So those are our four exercises. Our push-ups, our little rotating jump squats, dips, and switch kicks. This workout will take us 11 minutes, okay? So far, our longest workout has been 8 minutes. I'm gonna push the boundaries a little bit. We're gonna venture off into double-digit land. 11 minutes, so be ready. Let's go. All right, guys, here we go. I'm setting the clock up. Follow my lead. It's gonna be 30 seconds every exercise. We're gonna start with one exercise first. It's gonna be our push-ups. Then we're gonna take a 30-second break, and then I'll kind of lead you from there, okay? So let me get this clock going. All right, in about 5 seconds, we start with our push-ups. Our shoulder width apart, hips in, abs and glutes tight. Let's go, 30 seconds. Make sure we're breathing as we're pushing. You have to go to your knees. This is what it looks like. About 8 seconds. All right, we get a 30-second break. Oh my God, I'm hot already. 30-second break. We're gonna go 2 exercises in a row, okay? So we'll do our push-ups again, and then we're gonna get right up to our feet, and we're gonna go into these little jump squats where we're reaching across your body as we hop those feet out, okay? So 5 seconds, we're gonna go push-ups. Second round here. 2 exercises in a row, let's go. Hips stay in, abs and glutes tight. And breathe. Now 10 seconds. Keep pushing. All right, right into the squat. So hop out, reach across. Get down in that squat. Try to keep that back nice and straight. Shoulders and chest up. Hop the feet in and back down. We need to modify. We're not jumping. We can always march the feet in here, okay? It's a little bit less impact. 5 seconds. Perfect, relax. 30-second break. We're gonna add our third exercise, okay? We add the dips into it next, all right? So get up, be next to something, chair, bench, whatever. Again, so I gotta catch my breath. 3 exercises in a row, push-ups first in 10 seconds. All right, deep breath, 2 seconds. Here we go. Breathe, 10 seconds. Getting tough. Come on, push, and push. Up into that squat, right into it. Reach across. About 10 seconds. Now we're going into dip. Right here. And push. We're going to use your tricep. Which is still pretty fatigued from the push-ups. Stay close to the box. And push. 5 seconds. And relax. Shake it out, catch your breath. Now we're gonna go all 4 exercises in a row. We're gonna add those switch kicks to it. This will be our last time with our push-ups. We're going about 15 seconds, catch your breath. If you need water, These little breaks is when you get it. I'm already spent. If I was filming, this shirt would be off. It's hot. Ready? Let's go. Right here, we stay right alongside whatever you're using. Oh, my arms. 10 seconds left. They burn. 5 seconds. Last couple dips. Ah, man. Switch kicks again. I'm dripping. You better be sweating over there. Keep moving, even if it's this. Move, move, move. 10 seconds. 2 seconds. All right, perfect. All right, big deep breath. This is it, we're down to one final exercise. It's that switch kick. Catch your breath, can you switch kicks? One more time, and we are done. All right. We started strong. We finished strong right here. 3 seconds. Do not stop. Let's go. All the way to the end. There's only 30 seconds. Halfway, 15 seconds. 10 seconds. 5 seconds. And we are done. Let me pause this clock. Great job, guys. 11 minutes. We got the upper body, we got some lower body, a little rotation, a little cardio. Snuck a little bit of everything in. That is an example of one style of pyramid training that we do here at the shop. A little taste. I usually have the guys do about 7 or 8, our super pyramids and our super duper pyramids. So we'll call that our mini pyramid. 11 minute mini period. Period. 11 minute mini pyramid. We made it to the top, to the bottom. We're done. I'm tired of talking. You did an awesome job. If you have any questions or concerns about anything health and fitness related, shoot me an email, rich@healthyfitbootcamp.com. Until the next workout, kick butt, guys. Thank you.